doing?
We're gonna put some colored rear tires on this thing. If we're gonna do a burnout, we gotta do it right. So I got a red one and a blue one.
This is gonna be a different episode of State of the Build. I'm real excited about it. I'm your host, Emily Reeves, and you're watching the Peak Auto YouTube channel. This is the Independence Chevelle. That is Derek Beery of Vice Grip Garage. Of course, you know who he is because he's a legend. And this is gonna be a really fun episode. Let's get to it. Not a typical location for a State of the Build. Derek and Alex Taylor and I are at an amazing spot called Little Talladega, which is an Airbnb that's like the ultimate gearhead's dream, especially if you're into drifting. They have drift cars here, go-karts. It's a badass place. And yeah, called the Drift Mansion as well because of that. But this is going to be a really exciting episode. I've just realized that out here, while it's a beautiful day, it's really windy, we're gonna pull it inside this building so that we don't have wind noise for y'all. And I get to drive it in. I need to learn race car things.
Just crank the key, it should fire up.
Well, shoot, man.
Oh, I gotta turn the battery on. Now you're good.
Let's give this a shot.
So there's that.
Well, all right then. Dude.
Back out through the window.
All 540 of them cubes singing to us. That was. Now I'm ready to do this video. There she is.
540 cubic inches, lower compression, so we can run some boostesses on it. So it's Pro Charge, about 9 PSI, 9, 10 PSI. So with this setup and configuration, it's right around 1,000 horsepower. And we've got a surge tank here for extra cooling capacity. So additional water over there. And it's been through a few different renditions. We moved the power steering, we moved the catch can, stuff like that. As we've done a few different burnout shows, you kind of figure out what needs to be improved, but It's fairly angry and does a pretty decent job, I'll tell you that.
So what transmission are we working with, and did you have to do rear end work to withstand all of this power?
That's where it gets a little sketchy. So we've got a Harman Performance 4400 in this, reverse shift pattern. That does fantastic. However, it's a stock drive shaft and stock 10 bolt rear end.
What?
With a Lincoln locker in it. And we see speeds of around 170 miles an hour in the burnout pad. So it's a little dicey. We do have a drive shaft loop and stuff like that. We do have a 12 bolt back at the shop ready to go in. So we're fixing to make that improvement because that's super, super sketchy. But it does have a TRZ. I don't know if you made it see it. Got a TRZ rear sway in the back.
Lots of weight reduction here. Oh, yeah. Thank you, Mother Nature.
We did a wall tap on that.
We did.
Oh yeah, it was a pretty good one.
And then it's got QA1 double adjustable rear shocks. So we eliminated all the wheel hop and all of that. And then of course, you gotta pull a boat, so we put a hitch on it. You know, guys got a fish, stuff
like
that.
That's right.
And then the fuel system, this has been through a couple different renditions. Looks spacecrafty, but it has a reason. This is the main fuel cell, so you can use this for just, it's a street car, believe it or not. All the lights work, horn, turn signals, everything. You can run pump gas, whatever. And if you want to run ethanol or race fuel or whatever, you can turn, there's two fuel pumps. There's one in here, one in here. You could turn this one off, because this one pumps into this tank. Drain this down and then just fill it with race fuel at the track, and then you got instant race fuel. You don't have to empty any tanks out or anything like that. But when you're on the pad, we're on both pumps and it fills this tank, and then we have zero fuel swash that way. That fuel pump's wholly enclosed, so there's no starvation of fuel and no slosh or anything like that. And then it's on, we got a flex fuel sensor in here and all that stuff. So right now it's on pump gas, but you know, guy can run ethanol. Wants to, I guess. This doesn't close anymore from our last event. She got a little bented up. I'm trying to think. It was quite a while since we last looked at the car. We put in door cards, custom door cards. My friend did those.
Dude, those are cool.
Yeah, they're pretty neat. You know, we got all 10 in the back. We added bars to the roll cage so we could do sick week. We got the new Holley dash in it. Bunch of gauges. We put rugged radios in because you can't have a conversation in here.
No way. Otherwise. No way. So loud.
It's pretty loud. The exhaust, although it looks funny, has a purpose. The way that it points towards the rear of the tires in burnout competitions.
Ooh, it blows the smoke.
It blows the smoke back like 100 feet. It's pretty cool.
Dude, that's a killer burnout machine mod right there.
Yeah, kind of trick stuff, you know. We're just trying to put on a good show for folks. And, you know, volume of smoke is one of the things that you're rated, scored on in contests. I'm learning this as I go. So that's what we decided to do there. And that's these tires. We always run colored tires, so blue and red. And then we have the slotted mags for, you know, doing stuff on the streets.
Those guys. Yeah. Dude, this car is so sick.
It's a lot of fun.
It is so freaking cool.
Yeah. It's been through several renditions. I know we're going to keep it. The body is, you know, there's a couple dents here and there and some scratches. But, you know.
Were there? I hadn't noticed.
Well, I mean, like this right there, if you look close.
Oh, yeah. If you look real close, you can find some blemishes. But
we
you
love
know
it.
What? That's what makes us who we are.
Yeah.
This has a lot of character. And she's freaking rad. It's so cool. I love this in the grill too. Oh my god.
Yeah, it started with the 454.
Of course it did.
We had to update the old badge.
You got to put the 540. So we have our little duct tape mod. And this is just
barely
hanging
here.
I love it.
Yeah.
Dude, I love in-person state of the builds. As you guys can see, we're at a really cool location. We just had the honor, absolute honor, of shooting something really cool together along with our friend Alex Taylor, and we're so excited for y'all to see it. We can't tell you anything about it right now, but you'll know when it comes out.
It was good.
Because
it was really good.
It was a freaking blast. Because we have this place for a little bit longer, and we've yet to really leave any rubber on the track, I think we need to fix that.
Mazel.
Let's load up.
Can't even tell it's there. Blends right in.
This side has a door. Do I get to watch you crawl through the window, sir?
Oh no, I guess. It's gonna be something else.
Do you usually crawl through this side and then over, or do you?
No, this just broke. I think something happened with my lock, but I'm super lazy, so I'm definitely not gonna fix that. I'm just gonna struggle getting in and out.
Are you gonna crawl through the window?
I am, right now.
All right.
It's like the old stock car days.
Man, you're doing this with ease. Oh, come on. You've done that so many times.
Well, I ain't as nimble as I once was, I'll tell you that. I'm actually in a lot of pain right now. Let's not talk about it.
Oh my God.
All right, I'll pull it out and we'll get set up.
Okay.
It's a lot more G-forces than you would think, huh?
I couldn't believe it! We were not going fast!
No, it swings
pretty
hard.
But it's like, it does!
Yeah.
Oh my God!
You can see how this gets addicting. It's so fun. I'm so fun.
So jacked right now.
We need some rubbers?
Oh my God!
Rubber chucks!
I gotta go see! Of all time. Oh my God. Oh my gosh.
I'm looking that way.
What an absolutely awesome episode of State of the Build this was. To see this car go from like totally apart to a burnout machine, holy cow, and we got to hear it and ride in it. So awesome. Huge thanks to Derek at Vice Grip Garage and Peak for having us. So freaking cool. If you guys haven't joined the Peak Squad, get on it. The website's great. There's lots of benefits to being a Peak Squad member. And you know what? Drop a subscription, like this video, comment down below, tell us your favorite part. And if you have any suggestions for other folks you want to see on this series, drop me a comment there as well. We'll see y'all soon.